Long years are all in style this season, sir.
Come, Joseph. We have not much money.
But Mary, you are heavy with child. You cannot walk.
Oh, take him. A gift. He's yours.
Oh, thank you, sir. May God bless you.
No. What made me do that?
And Nestor, who just a minute before was about to give up, suddenly had the strength to carry Mary all the way to Bethlehem.
They traveled through the desert, but hadn't gone too far, when winter clouds no longer let them see their guiding star.
It was a terrible sandstorm. Nestor realized he could save himself by bolting and running for shelter. But then his ears, his very special ears, heard.
Whispers? Tilly! That little poem of hers.
Your ears can do a wondrous thing no other ears can do. The sounds they hear will guide you on a path that's straight and true.
And you may save another as your mother once saved you.
I will guide you now, Nestor.
That voice! Not Tilly. You are.
Listen to the angels and follow.
I will follow them, Mother.
Nestor had a secret, only he could hear the sound, as the angels gave directions to the ears that dragged the ground.
And guided by the angels, he continually carried Mary through the blinding storm, his great ears protecting her and the precious miracle within her. And as suddenly as it came up, the storm went away, and when the desert sands settled,
look! Bethlehem, you've gotten us through.
Thank you, little donkey.
Nestor took him right into Bethlehem, crowded with the multitudes come for the Roman census. And as you know, all the inns were full up. Nestor didn't know what to do. And then he thought back, and he remembered how warm and beautiful a stable could be for a baby when his mother was close.
And so it was that Nestor found the manger where they stayed, where kings and wise men bowed before the baby where he lay. Mary bore our Savior, Nestor brought them there, a gift of love.